Talking about an America changed because of the shooting on February 14th that took place in Parkland. Sadly, we've been through this before, but there's a sense, I don't want to speak for you guys, that this is different.
In fact, Kellyanne Conway said that a moment ago with us. And Brian, when you listen to the students who survived the shooting in Parkland last week, and that man right there, we talked to him in the first hour. His daughter was killed at Columbine.
Rachel.
There you've got a young woman and a young man, both were at Parkland. If you missed their comments yesterday on the channel, it is, in the history of the Fox News channel, this was one of the most riveting, raw, compelling things we have ever telecast, and here's a portion of it.
All the school shootings, it doesn't make sense. Fix it. Should have been one school shooting, and we should have fixed it. And I'm pissed, because my daughter I'm not going to see again. She's not here, so we all work together and come up with the right idea, and it's school safety. It's not about gun laws right now.
I would just like to say thank you for leading this country. You're a great leader, and I appreciate the direction that the country is going in. We all need to realize that we all have different points of views, and that we need, this solution is not going to be a singular thing. It's going to be multifaceted. This is not just Parkland anymore. This is America. This is every student in every city and everywhere. It's everybody.
There needs to be a significant change in this country, because this has to never happen again. And people should be able to feel that when they go to school, they can be safe. And because there needs to be a change.
But I just have so much respect for the men and women who showed up, and everybody in that room was affected somehow. And you had a president listening, and you had a president trying to take in the diversity of opinions. And the one thing he came out with that he said is, you know what I'm hearing? You know, I'm thinking that one thing that would have stopped this guy would be if there were the teachers, once trained, were maybe able to act, because the first responders, as he met with personally, couldn't get there for 10 minutes, which, by the way, is rapid. But when you get there in a school of 3,000, where do you go?
We're going to do something about this horrible situation that's going on. We're going to all figure that together. We're going to be very strong on background checks, very strong emphasis on the mental health of somebody. It's called concealed carry, where a teacher would have a concealed gun on them. You would no longer have a gun-free zone. Next week, the governors are coming in from most of the states, and we're going to have a very serious talk about what's going on with school safety. We're fighting hard for you, and we will not stop. We will not stop. We're going to get there. Thank you for pouring out your hearts, because the world is watching, and we're going to come up with a solution.
A couple of things. Number one, do you know what this president's doing? Not only is he changing the presidency with the Twitter and the constant conversation he's having with the American people, this is the fourth, fifth time on a major topic, a major issue, he's opened up the curtain. And he said, I'm not going to give you a script. I'm going to tell you what I'm going through and how I do things. And you can make your judgment at home on how I'm doing. And I think who's ever in the communications department that it continues to take the so-called risk of open up the curtain, letting the American people see an unscripted situation,